Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how to quickly and easily create sample data in Numbers. So I'm working on building an online course right now that will teach people how to use Mac Numbers. And in doing so, I'm using a technique all the time that I wanted to share with you that could help you if you're developing a spreadsheet. And that's the ability to create sample data very quickly. So for instance, say you're creating a spreadsheet and you want to keep track of inventory in stores. So you've got various products and you also have stores. So store A and let's say you wanted to create sample data for all of this. Now imagine if there were 100 stores and there were 15 different products. You know, entering a number, you know, just typing in something random takes up a lot of time and your data really isn't truly random. Say you just want to have an inventory number between 100 and 200. Well, you could put a formula in here and use rand between. So I started typing rand and I get some hints here and I'll hit rand between and allows me to put a lower amount. So let's say I want minimum of 100, maximum of 200. And then I can copy that and paste that through here and I get all these random numbers. So great, I've got random data. The only problem is it'll change every time something else changes in the spreadsheet. So I enter a number in here, 0, and you can see all those numbers change. So a way to keep this consistent so I can test out ideas and how this table works is I can select it all and I'll copy and then immediately paste formula results. And when I do that, now if I look here, I select a cell and it says the actual value is that value. There are no more formulas in here. This stuff won't change anymore because these are numbers just as if I had entered them manually. And let's say, for instance, if I wanted to create a some footer cells here and do some prices. So let me put some footer cells here. Let's shrink the table up. And in this one, I'm going to put the price. And let's say I want these values here to be between 20 cents and 50 cents. So what I could do is I could do rand between, but that's only for whole numbers. But that'll work out fine because let's do cents. So 20 and then 50 is the upper. And then I'll multiply the result by 0.01. And there I go. I get that. I'm going to copy. I'm going to paste this formula across. And it will change anytime I change anything. So I'll do the same thing. I will select it all, edit, and I'll copy and paste formula results. Now these are static numbers here. So now I can do things like create a total, multiply by the price, and paste that across. Let's go and create these changes to currency. So now I've actually got maybe a spreadsheet that's kind of working for what I want. These numbers are static. I can change them to see how something in the spreadsheet changes and make sure I get things working right. And then I could clear out the data and enter in the real data later on. Now that I know my formulas work right, my table looks good, and everything's going to work great. This works especially well for charts. I'm going to undo that here and say if I want to do a chart with this information, I can do, say, a scatter chart here for all these numbers and see whether or not this works for me and how I want to adjust this chart with sample data. And then later on, when I have real data, I won't have to then scramble to work on the chart. The chart would already be exactly like I want it, even before I had my first real number.